it reduced. Others want it scrapped entirely. What do you make of these comments, the thoughts, the suggestions of well-meaning Ghanaians?
I think when there's any policy, everybody needs to express their opinions. And we have experts that can express proper opinion on those issues. So it's always better for people to discuss, have a proper discussion, get informed analysis done. Then the government can also make a decision out of that. I've heard several people, something that because of financial inclusion and the mobile money is the most financially inclusive. And therefore, those who do not have access to banks or the unbankable, they are using the mobile money more. So if you want to tax it, it means that you're going to tax the poor more, or the poor are going to bear the brunt. It makes sense to think that way. Others are also of the opinion that, well, the mobile money, and for that matter, electronic transaction arrived, and government need to make money out of there. But there has to be a gradual process. Instead of maybe starting from about 1.75, maybe 1% or 0.75 would do.
I've even heard 0.5 from Theo Champong, yeah.
Exactly.
On Newsfile.
And others are also saying that the threshold is too small. 100 cedis per day is too small. And you have a minister saying that if you can send 100 cedis a day, it means you are not poor. And I don't know where she got that logic from, that if you can send 100 cedis a day, you are not poor. I don't know how she is defining her poverty line. Anyway, so these are some of the discussions that are going on. Mm. And everyone is legitimate because when a policy is coming, you have to look at what the impact will be.
Mm.
Whatever happens, of course, for every policy, there will be gainers and losers. You cannot get everybody to be a gainer. But you want to look at the majority should be gaining. If the majority are worse off, then it's not a good policy. At least those who should be impacted negatively should be in the minority, should be very, very minimal.
Mm.
And even that, across something compensating variation, you need to find a way of compensating them so that those who are gaining will be able to compensate those who are losing to some extent so that the damage is limited. So it's good discussion that we are having.
Mm.
And I'm hoping that Parliament, in their deliberations, will also take into consideration the views that are being expressed by the academics, the business community, the financial experts, and all the people that are expressing their opinions and they're offering their expert analysis. I think Parliament and government should take all these things on board in approving or disapproving the e-levy in particular.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that the discussion is good, and we are all getting to learn a lot of things. Just that there are also some conflicting information as to the applicability of this e-levy. So government need to come out properly, communicate clearly, let us know what is involved, what is not involved. If I do transfer from my bank to another bank or to a customer in another bank or from one of my bank accounts to another bank account, would I pay?
If it's your own bank accounts, what we've been told is that you will not pay. But if you're transferring money from your account to another person's account, then you'd be paying. But like you said, there's a bit of confusion, and so clarity is needed. We're still live on Facebook. And listen, go check out some projects that has been done in this country called Ghana. Some projects. And many of these projects are done with the taxpayers' money.
Yes.
Now, for the one that we're talking about currently, and I'm referring to the e-levy, what we've been told is that it's going to be used for youth employment, cyber security, public transport, entrepreneurship, digital and road infrastructure, amongst many others. Now, if we want such roads, and like we're showing on Facebook, and I still encourage my listeners to be there on